Coming up on 22 minutes after 11, I'm Nick Harcourt, your host. It's Morning Becomes Eclectic here at 89.9 KCRW. I think it was a couple of years ago last time we saw Sia, and she's back with us this morning. And this time, the album's out.
Hello.
How you doing?
Oh, pretty high-level anxiety.
Not as much as you could have, as you did last time. I remember last time you were here, you were very, very nervous and all that.
But now I've had loads more therapy, so now I can hide it better.
Yeah, exactly. And you've done the show before. You've been in LA a while as well, I think, right?
Yeah.
So why don't we throw it over to you guys? Introduce the band in the studio with you this
okay,
morning.
Okay. On guitar and bass, we have Chris. And over there on the piano bits and pieces, we've got Greg. And should I be saying your last names as well? Because I'm not sure I remember them. Maybe you can shout them out, and that would be helpful, wouldn't it? What's your last name, Chris?
Bruce.
Chris Bruce. Brilliant.
Bruce.
Greg Kirsten,
Bruce.
I remember. Dave Palmer, I know that one. Joey Warnicker and Ryan
Cross
on the cello.
All right. Well, welcome, everybody. Yeah, it's see your learning last names here on the fly in the studio.
Yeah.
You should feel at home here. You've been here with 07 a couple of times,
mm-hmm.
Second time on your own as well. Let's throw it over to you guys for a set. Okay. We'll come back and we'll catch up with conversation with Sia. She's live on Morning Becomes Eclectic.
Thanks, babe. This is Don't Bring Me Down. And we're going to do a Chrissy, well, actually it's a Pretenders cover, but it's written by Ray. Ray, what was his name? Greg, do you remember? Or anyone? Ray from the Kinks? Ray Davies, yeah, he wrote this, I Go to Sleep. And I'm just talking sort of while people sort of, fall asleep. swap around in the room, you can't see what's going on, I'm going to describe it to you. People climbing over stuff, changing instruments. And, okay, we're going to do it. I Go to Sleep. Distractions? Thank you for your patience. I think that
See you on Morning Becomes Eclectic. It's 89.9 KCRW. Finishing up with a track that probably one of the first ones we heard you do, actually, a 07 song. And I Go to Sleep. That was a Pretenders hit, right? Wasn't that
the thing
that Ray Davies wrote when he was with Chrissy Hynde?
Yep.
Of course, they hate each other now, but that's how all good relationships end.
Not true.
So let's catch up a little bit. And I'm thinking it's got to be almost 2 years ago the last time you were here with your material, because your album Color the Small One came out over in Europe, and you came in and you did a I think Joey was with you at that time,
yeah,
and Dave
Joey
was with
and
you
Greg
as well
too.
And what's been going on in between then? I mean, you did the second 07 album, you did the big tour with those guys as well. Tell us what's been going on.
I got dropped
By the label in the UK?
By the label in the UK. Okay. But that was the first thing that happened. I tried to deliver my next album. I wrote a pop album and they weren't really vibing on that. And so I got dropped. And then what happened? And I just started working more on that pop project and writing another album. And I finished the next 07 album. I did that with them and we finished that. And then that 6 feet under thing happened.
Well, we should talk a little bit about that, because, I mean, obviously our audience is very familiar with you. I don't know how many copies of this thing have been sold on import because people don't take any notice of it, but I can guarantee it's hundreds, 12. At least in LA. 12, yeah. 12 or 13. And so, you know, we've got this kind of history here on Morning Becomes Eclectic and at KCRW with you. And then the guys at 6 feet under who also work here, Gary and Thomas.
My best friends.
Picked that track.
My best friends in the whole world.
And put it into the end of 6 feet under, where they looped it and it ran for like 2 hours or something at the end of 6 feet under, where they wrapped it all up and everybody carked it.
Apparently amazing. Oh, you might have spoiled the end of some people, by the way. Me included. I haven't seen it yet. I'm looking forward to seeing it.
Everybody dies.
I'm pretty nice. That's so cruel. thanks. No, thanks. that happened.
But
then now everyone wants to sign me again. And
but they die in interesting ways.
The people, yeah, interestingly.
Yeah, but obviously that
basically saved me.
That
from
got a whole bunch of stuff going, right?
A lifetime of dog breeding in Australia, which actually is my second job preference.
Yeah. Kelpies?
I was thinking, actually, that's funny. No, Canterfield Terriers.
Oh, nice.
Long-legged Jack Russells.
For those who don't know, Sia is actually originally from Australia, and they have a wicked sense of humour down there, at least in Adelaide. That's where you're from, right?
Yeah, I thought you were going to say, for those who don't know, Sia is a dog lady.
Mm. No, I wouldn't say that, Sia.
Well, I am.
Sia's a dog lady.
Yeah.
Canterbury Terriers.
Yeah.
You learn something new every day.
Yeah.
So obviously a lot of attention generated by, this always happens with me and
I
you.
Yeah, I know, sorry, because I get off subject. But yes, blah, 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 blah. Now everyone loves me again. Oh, thanks to the telly. Yep.
Okay, so now it's the second set of music from... No. So it's got to feel good, though. I mean, you know, the album's two years old.
Even the ones that dropped me have offered to re-sign me.
That's pretty funny.
For any deal, which is just hilarious. You know, I love that.
So the album is out today, right?
It is.
On Astralworks.
Mm-hmm.
Good for those guys. I know they were trying to get this last year as well.
Yeah,
And there was a point, I guess, where the people who dropped you weren't sure if they wanted, even though they dropped you, they weren't sure if they wanted to let the album go to somebody else.
Yeah.
But happens. But finally, it happened.
Normal. Are we going to talk after the songs, or is this it?
No, this is it. So if you got anything to say, say it now.
I wanted to ask you a question because I think it's hilarious, personally.
Okay.
So the question is, if you could have it's a choice, right? It's a choice question. If you could have a mouth that was exactly like a butthole, with hairs and everything, right? And it looked like a butthole.
Mm.
Right?
You did ask me if you could say that word before we got on air. I had no idea what the context was going to be.
Or you could have a beautiful, luscious mouth. It looked like a butthole all the time. This is for a year, right? Or you could have a really beautiful, luscious mouth, beautiful lips, beautiful, sexy, luscious lips, but you would poop out of it once a day without warning.
God. Yeah.
What would you take?
Me personally?
Yeah.
There's a place in the valley where I would go and they'd probably sort it all out. I don't know.
No, you can't have plastic surgery. You can wax the hairs and stuff. But
yeah, that's what I'm talking about. All right, so we'll go back to the second set. It's Sia Furler. I'm wondering, why did you have to tell me that? Was there a particular reason?
It was merely a question. I didn't do the poo sand. Which one?
Okay. Sia.
This is a bit of poo sandwich cut off your mother's leg.
Yes, thank you very much. We're going to throw it back to Sia for another set. I have no problem with what you say. I just don't know where to go with it. You're basically just like, where do I go?
Okay,
the valley.
Sorry.
That's all right.
I'm just going to sing a really deep, serious song now.
Please do. Actually, the next song you're going to sing us is a new song.
Yeah.
It's called Lentil. I'm not going to ask what it's about.
Okay.
All right.
Probably best. I don't think people will feel it as much if I tell them.
Possibly not.
Maybe we can tell them later.
It's good to see you. Thanks for bringing the guys in.
Thanks. Sorry.
That's all right. We're going to wrap it up with another set. We're going to come back and give away some copies of that CD. There's a show tonight, actually, an in-store over at Amoeba, and you can go up to see her and ask her about dogs and, you know.
And I can ask you a few questions.
All sorts of things. And then tomorrow it's at the Hotel Cafe, although I believe that's pretty much sold out, so don't go down there.
Or do. Do and just hang out.
Yeah, hang outside.
Yeah. There'll be a street party going on. Me and the dogs. Okay, this is a lentil. You were waiting for me, adore me, you saw me. As I wish the whole world could. You would never hurt me, desert me, or work me for all the things you thought you could. You would lick the tears from my eyes when I cried. How I miss you when I was gone. Hurt me so to leave you, deceive you, I needed you. I believed in you. Oh, I never meant to let you down. I'll wait with a stake in my eye. Never meant to let you down. I'm trying not to fall apart. All I have is pictures and stitches and riches. Money can never buy what you gave. Though my heart is aching and breaking, I'm taking most of what you sent my way. I want just to hold you, unfold you. I told you I am coming back for you. I know we will be okay every day. The sun shines a little brighter. So exciting doing that new tune. First time we rehearsed that yesterday. That was really good. This is gonna, we're just, more people are moving around and stuff. I can describe them. Actually, Dave's wearing a fantastic outfit today as he moves around. He's wearing an all-in-one green pantsuit, stripy beanie. He also wears his sunglasses inside and at night. So this is a tune. This is the one. This is the one that's brought me back from the dead. Breathe me.
Again, and I feel alone.
Somersault. Hi. Sorry, we're doing dead sound. You want me to talk? I just keep talking. I can do it. I can do it.
No, don't talk.
I can do that too.
Morning Becomes Eclectic at KCIW. C is our guest. Thanks to C and the band for coming in today. Appreciate it. Good to see you.
Yeah, you too, babes.
The album's coming out, as we said, today. Are there any plans for any touring? I know right now you've
Yeah? I think we're going to do a tour in April.
Okay. So maybe we'll see you again. I know you're at the Hotel Cafe tomorrow night. We'll talk about that in a moment. Give away some tickets as well. And tonight over at Amoeba.
Yeah, 7 o'clock.
Can get down there and see Sia.
And hear exactly the same set.
Yeah. And talk and talk to her about Canterbury Terriers and lips, all sorts of things. Take it easy, love.
Ciao, Nara.
All right. Sia, our guest on the program this morning, and we'll come back and give away those tickets in just a moment. This is Morning Becomes Eclectic at 89.9 KCRW.